What's going on, family? Got the Top Dog here with another edition of the Listening Room. And today I'm using the Reebok A77. I'm doing this to show my buddy Marty. I was going to let him use this one, and he was trying to get the VU meters going. But I'm just doing this to show him that it does, in fact, record, even though those VU meters aren't working. I'm going to step back there for a second. What you hear right now is actually what's coming from the computer. I'm going to switch it over to the nav. That's what's on the tape. So as you can see, it's going on there just fine. And I did test it earlier, like 3 o'clock this morning. So I knew this would work. But right now I got the Dramatics. And that's one of the tapes on there that, you know, I can play with and put different stuff on, take it off, and everything else. And it's not one of my good ATR reels, but yeah, that thing is working good. And as you can see right next to it, you got the big brother, the Reebok B77. But yeah, I'm happy with this. But anyway, it's a sort of a rainy Monday morning here in the listening room. I don't feel like going outside. Ain't got nothing else to do. So I said, you know, why not just come on in here and play with some music? So that's what I'm doing. Got my Pittsburgh Steeler cup with the coffee. I never look right when I'm looking into this camera. But anyway, gotta represent my Steelers. Let me see if I can find a view. When I got the Pioneer RT707, I think that I did that one with the iPhone. But I'm on using the OBS software today. I'm on transition over here. And if you look at the A77 that's playing, go to the right to the first stereo rack, and that's the RT707 sitting on top there. But yeah. So I'm sort of filling everything out here in the listening room, slowly but surely. I had went on one of the sites the other day, and I was showing what I have here in the listening room, and I did a wide angle picture and put it on there, but then I had to go in and list all the pieces that I had. But I think I forgot to list the Akai GX636 that I have that I'm letting Marty use right now. So I don't even know. Sometime in the future, whenever it comes home, I don't even know where it's gonna go. This room is full of reel-to-reels, and I don't have a whole lot of room to put anything else. So I'll figure something out, though. I always do. Let me go back to the webcam here. There we go. Got a little bit too much light in here. I got my external lights on today. I just wanted to try to make sure there's enough light in here to see everything using these webcams. I gotta try to figure something else out to use. I'm not trying to pay over $1,000 for a mirrorless camera. to do all of this. You know, if I were doing this stuff on YouTube to get paid, then yeah, I would try to put a lot more money into it because I would get the money back. But I'm not trying to get paid. I'm just having fun posting stuff here from the listening room. So I just can't see making that expenditure. The webcams that I have, you know, these are not any cheap webcams, so I spent enough just on those things. But I think I'm trying to look at the books and everything on my Revox B77 because, you know, as I've said before, you know, I had the invasive bladder cancer and the medication is cisplatin. When they were giving me that medication during chemo, it caused what they call chemo brain. It wipes out your memory. And it destroys your short-term memory. And it said that it's supposed to come back after you finish chemo, but I'm one of the unfortunate people that mine didn't come back. So I've been dealing with this ever since then. But I keep saying I want to make videos on different gear and everything, but it's hard to, I know what everything is called, but when I go to talk about it, then I can't remember what everything is called. And you can't make a video like that. So what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to go back to the book, make sure I got the names of everything correctly. And then I'll try to make a video right after that. That's about, I guess, my best chance of remembering everything. So we'll see how that goes. But yeah, I definitely wanna do one on that Revox B77. Cause I be honest to God, I'm telling you, I was so happy when I got the B77 because I didn't think I would be getting one because they're, you know, the prices are so high on them. But I was able to get this, and this B77 was new old stock. In other words, it hadn't been used. And a guy in Berlin was selling it, in Berlin, Germany. And he got it from he bought a store shed. And this guy that used to own a music store, and he sold reel-to-reels back in the day. And it was his storage, and it was in there. It was sealed in the box and everything. Had everything that goes with it. Now, that's why you see the dust cover on there, because those are hard to come by too. But you know, it had everything there. And I got this for a phenomenal price. And I was just, you know, the Lord just blessed me with making it so that I could get this. And it got a little damaged in shipment. The VU stuck, the right VU meter wouldn't work. Now, it was working before because he hooked it up to make sure that it worked and he sent me a video. But my brother from another mother, Big Matt, fixed me up, took it up there, and he put another VU meter in there, and that's really all it needed. Man, that thing is great. And I didn't have to worry about getting a reel-to-reel that, you know, the heads were worn down or anything like that. So I'm loving life right now. I'm gonna switch back over there to it. But I think I'll probably just spend most of the day in here just playing around, listening to music, recording music. And I don't have anything else to do. And like I said, it's raining out anyway, so I don't really wanna go outside, you know, and go out there and get wet. So I'll just stay right up in here and enjoy my music, have a good time. With the view that I have on there right now, you can also see that that Pioneer RT-707. The one to the right of that is the Pioneer RT-909. But the 707 will be going up to Big Matt, and he's going to put me some blue lights in there, and I want him to adjust the meters for me because they're off. But I think that's it. But I got that on the cheap too. Plus the guy gave me 15 store-bought tapes. They were mainly rock and roll, but I looked all those tapes up, and it's about $500 worth of tape there. And I only paid $350 for the reel-to-reel. He took $50 off of it because I got caught in traffic trying to drive down to Savannah to get it. So I made out like a fat rat on that. But I don't plan on selling the tapes. I need to go ahead and make a list. I'll put them on my channel, and if there's anything that anybody out there wants, then you know I'll just send it to you. You know, I'm not gonna charge anybody for it. I got it for free, so why am I gonna charge somebody else? But let me see where I'm at on the recording here. Yeah, this one is. Wow, I didn't realize it had so many songs. It's got 18 songs on it, so it's going to be recording for a while. But what I may do is turn that one down and do some recording. That's after I finish this video. I'll use the computer and bring the title software up and figure out something that I really want to make on this side of the room. And I'll be doing that on the TIAC A3300SR. That's the one that I normally use to record with, and that's the one that's right to my left that has the red reel on it. That's the one that I normally use to record. I'm gonna reach over here and turn this light off. See if there we go. Stop a little bit of that glare. Cause that's a portable light. I got it from Best Buy. But it's very easy to take that one, you know, anywhere I want to go. But what it was doing, I'm going to transition back over. Now you see where you can hardly see me. It was lighting up this whole area here. But it's also creating a lot of glare. So had to get rid of that. And I got another one of these set up over by the door coming into the room. But it's also my photography light over there also. That's the one that, if you look, let me switch back over here. Alright, now if you look to the right and up a little bit, to the right of the computer screen, that's one of the video lights that I have, and I have another one on the other side of the room. I have that one turned off because it was just creating too much. It was just too bright. So, trying to get a nice balance of what I'm doing here in the room, and sometimes it doesn't work right. Come on, show my techniques. I think I'm supposed to go up to DC the first part of next month, and there's a company up in a place up in Baltimore that does some reel to reels, and you know, Big Matt is so busy in this one with the problems that it has. I think I'm going to just take it up there with me and drop it off with them and let them fix all the issues that I have with it. Then when it's ready, I'll just go up there and pick it up. But I also want them to change out some of the bad capacitors that they're known to have. So I want that thing so that it's running for a long time to come. So I'm gonna let them go ahead and do what they need to do with that. So it might be just be making that trip up the road with me. But it ain't got nothing else to do. It's got a speed issue with that Techniques, and when you pull out the let's see, of course I can't remember what it's called, the button for the pitch, you have to pull that out to adjust it, but if you push the pitch button back in, it goes back to going slow. So I have to leave the pitch out and all the way to the right, and it is just a tiny bit off, but it's not really making any difference with the music. So I can play tapes and everything on there just fine. I can actually record on it just fine too. But I also have a problem with the button where you go from 2-track to 4-track. So I have to put a little piece of toothpick in there to hold it in one spot, so that, because I want it in 4-track. So I'm going to get those issues fixed with it. And, you know, if one day I decide I do want to sell it, then, you know, whoever gets it is going to get a darn good machine. But then I'll get good money for selling it also. You know, so I want to just make sure all of my gear is working properly. All right, well, family, I think I've rattled on long enough here. Like I said, I'm gonna be in here the rest of the day and just in here chilling, listening to music, having myself a good time. So anyway, let me get off from here for now. Until the next time, you got the top dog, and he's out of here.